U.S. Soccer's advice to new referees focuses on how to prepare for and deal with the everyday challenges of being an official and provides practical advice that encourages new referees to succeed and have fun. Making a good impression and taking care of all the pregame duties is important, but there is still a lot of work to be done during the game itself. Here are some of the most important points to remember as the referee. Running to keep up with play is part of being a good referee. It is impossible to make correct decisions when you are not in a good position. Even when refereeing small-sided games, get in the habit of being active and keeping up with play. Running and being active is not only a good way to get in position to make the correct call, but it also shows the players, coaches, and spectators that you are taking your responsibilities as the referee seriously. The best position to be in is the one that will allow you to make the correct call. As just mentioned, this means that you will have to be active and work to keep up with play. Positioning is something that becomes more natural as you gain more experience as a referee, but working hard is something you can do in your very first game. Despite your best efforts, you will not always be in position to make the correct call. Sometimes the ball simply moves faster than you can run and the speed of play increases as the level of competition increases. Don't get discouraged. This happens to referees at all levels, so it's important to maintain your focus and work rate. Your assistant referees are there to help you. Their signals are silent, so it is critical that you look at them regularly throughout the game. A good habit to get into is to make eye contact with your assistant referee on every dead ball situation and during play when you suspect that they may have information for you. Making eye contact is not simply a matter of looking in the assistant referee's direction. Your assistant referee needs to know you are looking at him or her, and then you should confirm the communication by using a simple gesture, such as a head nod or thumbs up. This gesture can be discussed in the pregame conference. Always use the diagonal system of control when you have assistant referees assigned with you. This is often called the left diagonal, which means that you run from the right corner behind you to the left corner in front of you. The left diagonal provides a guideline for referees. But remember that the best position to be in is the one that allows you to make the correct decision. If you are assigned to a game without assistant referees, you can appoint club linesmen to signal when the ball leaves the field of play. Remember that club linesmen cannot call offside or fouls, so this means you will have to work hard to cover more space and concentrate to make sure you are covering offside on both ends of the field. Clarity of your signals and the volume of your whistle will determine the kind of impression you are making on players, coaches, and spectators. As a referee, you want to do all you can to make sure this impression is a good one. Make sure you are signaling clearly by pointing in the appropriate direction with your arm extended and fingers held together. Blow your whistle firmly and with confidence. Your whistle is one of the ways you will communicate during the game, so make sure it's loud enough for everyone involved to hear. You can also make your whistle say different things by blowing harder or softer, blowing more than once, or changing the tone of the whistle depending on whether you just want to get the player's attention, to signal something happening that you don't like, or to stop play due to an injury or dangerous situation. Please be sure to keep visiting ussoccer.com to view additional referee education resources.